What is up, fellow boomers? It's Vo with How Boom Beach, and today I am bringing you a guide on the do's and don'ts of Boom Beach. I don't really know what to call you guys. I've been using the word boomers, but I don't know if that's gonna catch on. Maybe it's just me, but I'm not sure how I feel about that. But anyways, the outline of this guide is brought to you by someone on the Supercell forums. He goes by the name Backhoom George, so credit where credit is due. He did come up with a lot of these, but I asked him nicely, and he has allowed me to use it in a video because I found that his tips were very good, and that a lot of players should be told about these do's and don'ts. So first off, in the background, you're going to be seeing some gameplay that has no particular relation to what I am talking about, so anything that may go with what I'm saying is strictly coincidental, because I'm recording this audio separately. So anyways, the do's in Boom Beach, finally we get there. I'm probably gonna put a little annotation that skips to this moment in the video because this intro is taking a while. The do's in Boom Beach. First off, this is not Clash of Clans. It's never said to be Clash of Clans. Even though it's made by the same developers, it has some similar concepts, but Boom Beach is its own game, so don't treat it as Clash of Clans. The first thing that I would say for you to do is to rush your headquarters. Now, this is completely the backwards opposite mentality of someone that's been playing Clash for a long time, because in Clash, you're bred to max out everything, your defenses, your buildings, before you move on to the next town hall, because that's the way it should be, and you want to keep it that way, because if you rush your town hall, then you're putting yourself at a disadvantage in Clash Clans, because you're going to get less loot from fighting people that are should be easy for you, but since you've rushed and your troops are low level, then they're going to be more difficult to you to beat. So in Boom Beach, it's not like that at all. It's completely okay to rush your headquarters, and it's actually very easy to do so because the headquarters upgrade at such a fast pace, and it really is just encouraged. It's a different system. There's no penalty whatsoever for doing so. You don't slow yourself down. If anything, it helps you out. It opens the map up and brings more available bases and people to fight. There really is no consequences. There's no loot penalty or anything. So rush your headquarters. Do it. Just, it's completely okay. The next tip is for more high level players, I guess. But I mean, you do obtain statues at a lower level, but this doesn't have quite an impact at such a low level. But his second do is to hide your statues. Now, statues in Boom Beach are the things you get at around, I think it's HQ 6 or 7, something like that, and they give you boosts to resources, or in later levels you'll get boosts to like health, like building health, troop health, stuff like that. And what he's basically saying is to hide your statues, and you can do that by maybe either putting them behind trees, which I don't know if it turns translucent, I'm not sure about that. Or mostly you can put them behind archer towers. Archer towers are very great for this. They're nice and tall, and you can put stuff behind it, and they'll be pretty concealed, and you can throw your enemies off when they figure out that your buildings may have more health than what their levels may appear to be. So the next do on the list is to focus on offense more than defense. While offense takes a big play in this game, and you need to focus on offense more than you do defense. The more you attack, the higher your matchmaking goes. Matchmaking is the invisible system that Supercell has implemented into this game. It's not trophy based or medal based. The more medals you get does not mean the better people you will fight. It can have a correlation, because if you fight continuously and you keep beating people's bases, the matchmaking system pairs you with better people. So attacking more frequently and winning more frequently actually is what gets you higher up and attacking better players. It's not metal-based. But focusing on offense will help you fight tougher enemies and beat Hammerman and Dr. Terror and all those people. So here's another do for you guys. Do always protect your headquarters. Your headquarters is very important in this game, and unlike in Clash, you can't just put your headquarters outside and get a free shield and protect your resources. In this game, I believe that what Supercell's goal was to eliminate farming. They didn't want that to be a strategy. They wanted people to play the game the way they wanted it to, and I believe that when they made Clash of Clans that they didn't intend farming to be a method that people would use. So I guess with this game, they have made it where your headquarters is the basic goal of any attacker. It doesn't matter if they get 50%, 80%, or 90%, or even 99%, if they don't get your headquarters, then they don't win. So your headquarters is the most important thing that you need to protect. And even if your resources are outside and they get destroyed, the resources aren't taken unless your headquarters is destroyed. So the only thing you really need to focus on is to protect your headquarters. You don't have to protect resources because they won't get your resources if you have good defenses and you protect your headquarters. And I'm waving my hands around in the air at nothing so nobody can see me do this. Oh my god. See, another tip is to put your headquarters always to the end. So what he's trying to say is to put your headquarters, squish it all the way farthest in the back of the map. Try to get it as far back as you can, because that's usually the safest place for your headquarters to be. Now, I'm not saying that it'll be completely safe if it's squished all the way in the back of the map. I'm just saying that that's probably the best place for it. You need to kind of compensate by putting defenses in a way that it protects your headquarters, because putting it in the far back kind of makes it vulnerable from a flank if they flare their troops behind your HQ. But most of the time, putting your HQ in the back is a good idea. Alright, so now we're doing the don'ts in Boom Beach. You've learned about the do's, and now you want to know about what you should not do in Boom Beach. Never put your headquarters outside. Don't do that. Now, I've kind of briefly gone over it while I was covering the other subjects, but like I said, this isn't Clash of Clans. There's not farming. Putting your HQ outside will not benefit you in any way. You're losing medals and you're losing resources. You don't get a shield in this game. Don't rush your army level. Now, this is kind of debatable, but it makes sense if you think about it. If you rush your armory level, and that's just upgrading your armory from like 2 to 3 or whatever, you're going to start falling behind on upgrading the troops that are actually in the armory. And as you go up in levels, it's going to feel more daunting the more troops you're going to have to fill gold into. And if you kind of do it at a steady pace at each level, kind of try to max out your armory at each level, like upgrade all your troops at each HQ level, it's going to feel less overwhelming than if you skipped all the way to 10 and then finally started upgrading your troops. It's going to feel like it's taking up all your gold, and it's going to feel like it's taking forever. So going at a steady pace is probably a good idea. Don't leave out defense or offense. This is a big deal. Both take big plays in this game. Leaving out any of them is a bad thing. I mean, although offense should be prioritized over defense, if you leave out offense, you will suffer facing big opponents and stealing loot and medals. If you leave out defense, you will have a hard time winning defenses and protecting your loot and medals. You want to face opponents to gain loot and medals, also protecting them both too. Don't attack multiplayer bases every time and leave out non-player bases. This is pretty simple. There's a lot of people would probably like attacking player bases. I'm the kind of guy that likes attacking CPU bases because they provide resources, and it's, I don't know, I like winning. I like seeing myself win, and it makes me feel good. So don't leave out non-player bases or CPU bases, because they can be pretty useful for getting that extra amount of resources that you might need to put into an upgrade. or they can just be confidence boosters or to test out certain strategies slash troop compositions. There's all kinds of things that can come from non-player bases. Plus, they give you medals, and they can give you crystals or shards, so they're a big deal. You don't want to leave those out. Attack them. They're not like CPU goblin villages in Clash. They, besides providing lots of resources, they also provide numerous other things. Don't be that person that doesn't protect their non-defensive buildings. You don't want to count your non-defensive buildings out when you're making a base. You want to create buffer zones and place them in front of your defenses in your town hall to, if the opponent were to run out of flares, that those would suddenly get in the way. Putting out your resource buildings and stuff like that where they are easily destroyable, if that's even a word, gives the other player, the attacker, energy, and using that energy they could probably get the upper hand on you. So that's it for this video. I know it was pretty lengthy, and if you guys didn't know, I'm pretty new to commentating and making videos and stuff like that, so I would appreciate tips or anything in the comments if you want. Let me know ideas on future videos. I don't mind hearing them. And I hope this video was useful to you guys. That's the do's and don'ts of Boom Beach, and I hope you guys enjoyed. It's Bo with How Boom Beach, and I'm signing off.